intervention, because I think it's irritating at best, but also very frustrating when you hear your African brothers and sisters who continue to dismiss the race issue as if we are just looking for issues and we're just overly sensitive and that kind of thing. And you see that a lot. I mean, for example, when you saw the response to Chimamanda for saying, you know, a white man cannot define racism, and people say she's reverse racist, and, oh, we love Trump because blah, 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 blah. There's a willful ignorance, I find, sometimes, and dismissal of these issues. And I say, for me, that I think we need to also be particular. We need to talk about secular colonialism, right? That is why, for example, in South Africa, or even in Zimbabwe, maybe in Namibia, maybe to some extent in Kenya, will understand Black Lives Matter to a greater extent than, you know, for example, Nigeria, which is not a former secular colony. So the presence of white bodies allows us to see race in ways that it is invisibilized here in other African countries. And for me, to just understand the nexus of secular colonialism, and because I think also it's a false equivalence to say malaria kills lots of black people, but then there's black people being shot. This is state-sponsored violence. And it's almost a gratuitous violence against black people, such that